Tonight I'm wetting my whistle with Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout from Oxus Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as an easy drinking dark ale with the aroma of coffee and chocolate. Alright, that's the formalities out of the way. Now let's get to what we're actually here for. I am looking at the latest of the tools or pieces of test equipment that I have managed to convince Banggood to send me to stock up my shop. Oh, and I guess to promote their product. But mostly because I'm trying to get sponsors to stock my shop with tools. This is a Cat 5, Cat 6 coaxial cable tester. There's a certain amount of information on the back, but I think it's much more interesting to actually look at the device. So let's do that. First thing out of the box, it comes in this nice little zipper case. That's kind of cool. Instructions, we'll look at that later. We have a damaged in shipping female to female adapter. I think those are, yeah, that just clips back together. Cool. A little bit of padding, quality certification. Woohoo. Let's just dig into here. First of all, we got a BNC to two conductor RJ11, so telephone jack. We have RJ11 to clips. We have a couple of RJ45 cables. They are straight through. So when you're using this type of flat cable, the conductors just go straight across from end to end. So in order to have the conductors show up, in order for it to be a straight through cable, the ends have to be like that or like that. It looks like it's weird, but that's intentional so that it's straight through. Next, we have a cheap little set of earbuds. That's interesting. What else do we have here? It's like a USB cable. I'm assuming that is for charging it because it also comes with this little USB charger here. 100 to 240 volts in, 5 volts, 1 amp out. Just a basic little USB charger. Then there's that thing, which just allows you to couple. Oh. Well, it's not RJ45, that is RJ11. Okay. Let's look at one of these cable map boxes. There's 4 of them comes with it. This one happens to be number 3. And it's got a BNC on one end, and it's got the RJ45 connector on the other end. Anyway, there are 4 of those comes in the kit. Each one has its own number on it, and that's the number that it will identify itself as when it's talking to the main unit. Next, we have the little non-contact probe. It's kind of nice that it's got that. Aha! There is where the headphones go, and it has a charge port on the side of it. It has a 1400 milliamp hour, 3.7 volt lithium battery in it. Okay, it's got some charge to it. So that is just the pickup sensitivity. Oh, it's got a little light on it too. That's kind of nice. And then the main attraction. This is the NF858C from Noyafa, whoever that is. It has a charge port on the side. There's another battery compartment there. Same 1400 milliamp hour, 3.7 volt battery. On the side, we have an RJ45 scan connector and a port flash connector. On the top, we have an RJ45. We have a BNC. We have a VFL. What is VFL? Oh, is that a fiber connector? Really? I'll have to check on that in a second. Okay, let's see if this one's got some charge in it. Yeah, it does. Welcome to Choose Noifa. So our options are continuity, length, and scan. Setting, language, English, okay, backlight, auto off, contrast, version, back. Let's see what VFL is. Is that really a fiber connection? Oh, yeah. It's a fiber tester's best friend. It's the ruby red laser. Oh, not laser, ruby red light. So I think I showed that when I was playing with a fiber tool earlier. That actually, so you connect that to a fiber, any fiber. It looks like that'll work with SC or FT or that size of fiber, which is pretty common. And it just shines visible light down it so you can easily find the other end. That's great. So it'll test power over Ethernet. It'll test do flash, whatever that is. Does telephone testing and scan and length and continuity. Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Scan. I know what scan is. Scan is creating something that this guy can listen to. So when it gets close. Okay, so scan comes out of that one there. All right. Let me set up a quick demonstration, I think. Okay, so picture a situation where you've got a bundle of wires just running through a ceiling. You know where one end of them is in your LAN room or whatever, but you're not sure where they go. You just want to sort of follow them. And I mean, it's easy in this instance because I've got three different colored wires, but if they're all the same color, which they often are in an installation, and if you get some distance away from the cables and you can't tell anymore which one they are, it's that one. And again, this makes a lot more sense when you got a bundle of dozens of cables and they're all the same color and everything else. But yeah, that is just a super quick way of following a wire through random places. Super handy thing to have. Another feature that looks handy is cable length, especially if you have to run additional cables into a place where you've already got one run. You can just quickly scan and find the length of the thing. So that, I assume, comes off there. Notice I'm not using the manual at all yet. I've used tools similar to this at work, so I'm familiar relatively with how it works, but I'm just going to see how far I can get with no reference to the manual. So I'll push the OK. Typecat 5, sure. Units, meters, sure. Calibration, not worrying about that right now. Low data, not worrying about that right now. So let's just start and see what happens. So it says that pair 1 is open. Pair 2 is 6.8 meters. Pair 3 is 4.9 meters. And pair 4 is 4.4 meters. So I'm not sure why pair 1 is showing as open, but the reason that there's different lengths in the pairs is Cat 5 and Cat 6 and all these data cables are twisted pairs. Each of the four pairs of wires is twisted to help reject outside interference. Allow me to show you. Notice that the blue has the most twists per unit length, and the brown has the least, and then orange and green are again a little bit different. So in this case, probably the blue-white pair is going to be the longest pair in the cable, just because it goes extra distance. So don't be alarmed if you see that it's got different lengths for each pair inside the same jacket. That's correct. So I figured out what what one of the use cases is for this whole set of adapters here. You can get into clip leads like this through the coax and clip them onto a wire going into a bundle for doing the cable locate the same way. So I probably should have showed one of the more basic modes that most people would use every day on this thing before I started showing the fancy features. But anyway, the continuity mode. So we're connected again to the receiver. Continuity mode. Okay. I've just got it set for Cat 5 again. Start. And it just shows that the 8 conductors are all connected and connected straight through, which is good. Receiver and master, right? However, if you connect a different cable to it, wire 1 connects to wire 3, wire 2 connects to wire 6, wire 6 connects to wire 2, wire 1 connects to wire 3. That is what's called a crossover cable. It's a little bit old school. It's almost never used these days, although there are some older pieces of equipment that still require it. You notice I've got this cable marked as crossover. So the telephone mode would again be using this little adapter onto here, because normal telephony for old style landline just uses two conductors, which are the middle two on there. And then telephone mode, it gives you the status of the line. I don't have a landline here, so I can't test that. I'm assuming it will say on hook, off hook, or ringing. And there it will tell you the polarity and voltage of the line, which would typically be in the 40 volts range, plus or minus, somewhere between 40 and 50 volts, typically for just a normal off-hook telephone. But if you're doing work on landline telephones, that's handy. I'll come back to flash after I read the manual. We have a power over Ethernet or PoE mode here, which I'm assuming will tell you the voltage that it sees on each of the wires if there is PoE connected. But as I mentioned, I don't have anything PoE in the building, so we'll deal with that later. VFL, we looked at that. That's visual fault locator or visual fiber locator. That's a fiber connector underneath there. Record. Okay, so if you're doing wire mapping and stuff, then it will record that. Okay, settings. Aha, I have found what that port flash function means. You can connect this guy to a port on an existing switch, an Ethernet switch, and it will light up the port light on it without actually generating any traffic or causing problems. You can do either the normal mode or a PoE version. Okay, so there is my shop computer's router and just, you know, Wi-Fi for my shop. I've got this guy in flash mode. I'm connected to the flash port. Notice port 4 on the router, just before the LCD blinks on the screen of my meter here. That's one of those, not going to use it very often, or at least I'm not, but probably could come in really handy. So the only one, well, the only one that I'm interested in that we haven't played with yet is wire map. So let me just play with that a little bit off camera. All right, I've got these four wire map boxes connected up to random cables here. Then we go into continuity mode. I'll just stick with Cat 5 right now. These are all Cat 5e cables, so that should be fine. I go into continuity mode now. Before, I had it in 1-to-1 when I was using this guy, but now I'm going to take it into 1-to-4 mode and scroll down and hit start. And it identifies that this cable is connected to remote 3, which is this one, and that it is wired as a straight through cable. So let's try a different one. Let's try this one here. And that's remote 2. Let's try this blue cable here. Oh, you saw what I've got connected to it. Let's see if it'll do it. Yep, it shows up as remote 4. That one. Oh, hey, the beeping pattern changes. And it also shows that it is, huh, that's interesting. It showed up as the crossover cable like it should, but for some reason there's two pairs missing. Why is it not seeing those two pairs? Because we know these pairs do work when we tested it with this. Huh, that's interesting. And just for completeness, we'll test it with that one, which should be number 1, and it is. And that wire map mode is actually the main reason that I wanted this rather than a more basic tester, because I think I mentioned that I've got a new garage built, and I ran some Cat5e through conduit out to the garage while, you know, while the electricians had the trench open. Why not, right? But me being, you know, in a hurry and lazy, I didn't bother marking them. So the whole reason for choosing this one next, the last time Banggood said, hey, do you want some stuff, was to get this wire map functionality so that I can map those out. Okay, so here we are in the land closet of my house. Yes, it's literally a closet in the basement. And there's the two new cables that I ran out to the garage and terminated. I'll just plug wire mapper number 1 and 2 onto those guys. And then let's go to the garage and see if we can see them and see if I wired it right. Okay, here we are out in the garage. And as you can see, I've got my two Cat 5e runs into a jack that I hooked up earlier in the year. And I also got some RG6 out here just because you never know. Anyway, let's fire this guy up into continuity mode. We'll go in 1-to-1 mode. No, we need to be in 1-to-4 mode, right? And start, and we'll plug it into the bottom one and see what happens. And that is remote number 1 on the bottom. Perfect. And it's wired straight through with no errors. Nice. And then the top one. And that's remote number 2. Okay. So I can identify these, and I can only plug in the one that I need, or I can label them at the other end so I know which is which. Perfect. And that means I can take my used thrift store router here and hook it up. Just goes onto the keyhole slots there. And we'll go from this port 1. Sure, why not? Now, this is a router, but it's also got a switch built into it, and I'm using it as a switch. So I'm going to plug into one of the 4 switch ports back to the switch in the house. I'm not going to use the router port because I'm just going to use the router in the house to be in charge out here. There we go. Lance, what are you talking about out there? Well, you're just coming to see what I'm doing.
So we'll just take a quick look at Banggood's sale page for this unit. I will put a link down in the description, and if Banggood comes through with the discount code that they often do, I will put that down there as well. It is currently on sale for $89.99. Anyway, the regular price is US $129.99. So here is the basic specs of the thing, and this is pretty much copied straight out of the manual as well. You can come and take a peek if you were interested. Max testing range, 2,000 meters, 2 kilometers. The battery is actually better than the one that they spec, which is nice. And yeah, there's what you get in the kit, plus a bunch of cables and adapters and things. And there is the various functions. So there's one of the things that I'm not able to demonstrate because I don't have a PoE switch here, but it will show you the voltages coming in over the PoE line. So that's handy for checking. And that's the other thing that I don't have anything to test right now is the visual fault locator. So basically that just punches that red light down the fiber and you can see it blinking at the far end. And it really does jump out at you too if you got a bundle of unknown fiber. It's really easy to see.
So there we go. Just a quick look and test and run through its paces of this Noyafa NF85HC. Cable tester, measurer, cable length, cable mapping. Very cool little piece of kit. And I mean, there are cheaper ones available, like this little one that I have had forever. But the wire mapping feature and this non-contact tracing mode are super duper handy things to have. And those, I think, are the things that I'm going to use the absolute most on this. In addition to just verifying that I wired things correctly. Thanks to Banggood for sending this out for me and continuing to stock up my tool chest. Thanks to you guys for watching. Questions and comments down below as usual. There will be a link in the description to this thing in case anybody's interested. I will talk to you later.